Hello friends, welcome to wifistudy.com, one-stop destination for all competitive exam prisons, current affairs 2017, February 3rd week in English. So friends, in this video, we are going to provide you all the important material or the important content or the news which is relevant to your upcoming exam from the third week of the February. Friends, if you are weak in a vocab or not able to score good marks in a vocab, then you can purchase our pen drive course in which you will get assistive videos of 3000 words in which you will get a very short trick by which you will be easily able to remember all the vocabs. Apart from it, you will get a meaning in Hindi, synonyms, example, images. And if you access Y Vocab 24 app, you will get in 497 rupees. If you want an 8GB pen drive, you will get in 999. And if you have any query or you want to call, then you can use this number. And friends, if you want to prepare vocab from the application, then you can download our Vocab 24 app in which you will get a 10 new words, daily 10 new words from the Hindu editorial. And apart from it, you will get a practice test, translator, dictionary that will definitely able to provide a boost to your vocabulary. And friends, if you like this video, please subscribe so that we can provide you more videos, more content for the upcoming exam. So friends, let's start from the international section first. After that, we are going to cover national, then trade and banking, appointments, sports, everything which is relevant to your upcoming exam. So let's see the first international question. That is, the longest elevated bike path in the world has been opened in which country? So let's see the news first. After that, we will pick up the answer. So the longest elevated bike path in the China, in the world has been opened in the city in the southeast China. Okay, so this bike path, longest elevated bike path has been opened in the China. So your answer is D. And the capital of China is Beijing. Currency is Yuan. Renminbi. President is Jinping. And the Prime Minister is Li. 2017 UNESCO Natural Heritage Festival was held in which state? So UNESCO Nature Fest held in Himachal Pradesh. So Himachal Pradesh. So it was held in Himachal Pradesh. So your answer is Himachal Pradesh. The fest was held in a collaboration with the Wildlife Institute of India. Notably, Great Himalaya National Park was given UNESCO World Heritage Site status in 2014. So this Great Himalaya National Park is in Himachal. First of all, you need to remember. Second, it is also a World UNESCO World Heritage Site. And the headquarters of the UNESCO is in Paris. Director General is Irina Bokova. It was founded in 16 November 1945. And it has 195 members. Okay, so these are the important content that you need to remember. Which country is hosting 2017 Cobra Gold Military Exercise? So the US and Thailand has kicked off the 2017 iteration of the annual Cobra Gold Military Exercise, Asia's largest multinational drill. In over 30 years, Cobra Gold, which began as a bilateral drill between the US and Thailand, has now grown into one of the world's largest multinational exercises involving some 30 countries. Okay, so your answer is Thailand. The capital of Thailand is Bangkok. Currency is baht. Prime Minister is Prayut Chan-o-cha. What is India's rank in Economic Freedom Index 2017? So India's rank 143rd in Economic Freedom Index. Okay, 143rd. Well behind the our neighboring countries like Pakistan and all these nations. Okay, and you need to remember that the Hong Kong, Singapore is on the top of this index. So your answer is 143. World Day of Social Justice is observed on which date? So it is observed globally on 20th February 2017. And the theme of this 2017 year is preventing conflict and sustaining peace through decent work. Okay, so this is the theme of this year. And your answer is 20th February. Which is the world's largest arm importer country in the last 4 years? So India was the world's largest importer of the major arm between 2012 and 16, accounting for the 13% of the global total sales. Okay, and India increased its import, arm import by 43% between 7 to 11 and 12 to 16. And US is the leading arm exporter in the world. So these are the few things that US is the leading arm importer, exporter. India is the leading arm importer in the last 4 years. And India has 13% total share in the total global total sales of the arms. Okay, so these are the important things that you need to remember. And your answer is India. Now let's see some national questions. Which city has hosted International Coin Fair 2017? So in this fair, there are more than 2,500 coins from around 500 regions, including those from the time of the Emperor, Princely States, were on a display at the International Coin Fair, which was held in Thiruvananthapuram. Okay, so your answer is A. And this event also featured the Gilbert Lopez, who hold a Guinness Book of World Record for the largest coin collection. ISRO sends record 104 satellite in one go. Okay, so we made a special video on this topic, and if you want, then you can watch that video also. And in this content, you need to remember, first of all, that this 104 satellite is launched by the PSLV C-37, and it is its 39th mission from Sriharikota. Okay, and beating the previous Russian record of 37 satellites in one go. And there are three Indian satellites, Cartosat-2, then another one IRS, then another one also. So these are the three Indian satellites which was launched from this PSLV C-37. And apart from it, 96 satellites belong to USA and 5 from international customers of ISRO, that is Israel, Kazakhstan, Netherlands, Switzerland, UAE. And the headquarters of the ISRO is in Bangalore. It was founded on 15th August 1969. And right now, the chairperson of the ISRO is Kiran Kumar, A.S. Kiran Kumar. Which district was carved out of Darjeeling recently? So, a new district of Kalimpong was carved out of Darjeeling, which has been separate statehood demand since 1980, with the West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee making the formal announcement. Okay, so the name of the new district is Kalimpong. The capital of the West Bengal is Kolkata, governor is Keshrinath Tripathi, and it was founded in 26 January 1950. Which city is hosting 11 International Aero India 2017? Okay, so Bangalore is the city which hosted this event. So your answer is B. And in this edition, there is a nearby 549 companies with 53 aircraft gracing the event. What is the name of the early warning system recently induced in the Indian Air Force? So recently, one of our indigenously made warning system is induced in the Indian Air Force. So what is the name of it? Okay, so the name of that early warning system is Netra. Okay, Netra is the name of that, and it is made by the DRDO. Which city has hosted conference on next gen technologies? Okay, so there is one city which hosted this event, and this event was held in New Delhi. So your answer is D. Which state has launched e-prison project? So the GNK government has launched the e-prison project to enumerate jail inmates in the state, where numbers of detainees keep swelling during unrest. The information about jail inmates is currently being maintained manually. Okay, so they don't want to maintain the information of the prisoners manually. So that's why they introduce a new project named e-prison project. Okay, and your answer is JNK. Which scheme was recently launched by the Khadi and Village Industries Commission? So KVIC to make Khadi gown in each state. So they want to make 5 Khadi gown, and they want to provide a self-dependent service to the Khadi people, and would stop their retreat towards the cities. Okay, so these are the few aim of this scheme, and your answer is A. Which telecom operator will provide preloaded SIM card to foreign tourists arriving in India on e-visa? So BSNL will help the tourist to get a new SIM when they will arrive in India. So your answer is BSNL. And on this occasion, Dr. Mahesh Sharma, Minister of State and Tourism and Culture, launched the initiative of the Ministry of Tourism, Government of India, for providing preloaded SIM card to foreign tourists arriving in India on e-visa. And this initiative has been launched in association with the BSNL. Which city is hosting India's Panorama Festival 2017? So the festival which was hosted by the city is Port Blair. So your answer is B, Port Blair. Okay, Port Blair is the capital of the Andaman Nicobar, and it is in the South Andaman. Okay, there are four Andamans like North, Middle, South and Little Andaman. And between the Little Andaman and Nicobar, there is a channel named 10 degree channel, which separates Little Andaman and Nicobar. Okay. What is the theme of the Global Investor Summit 2017 held in Jharkhand? So the 2-day Global Investor Summit, that is Momentum Jharkhand, held in Ranchi. So your answer is Momentum Jharkhand. Capital of the Jharkhand is Ranchi. Chief Minister Raghubar Das, governor is the Draupadi Murmu, and formation of this state was in 15th November 2000. Which state has decided to constitute a tourism board? So there is one state who want to constitute a tourism board to provide a very good facilities to the tourist and to enhance the tourism policy. So your answer is Madhya Pradesh. MP set up tourism board, and the capital of the MP is Bhopal. Chief Minister is Shivraj Singh Chauhan. Governor is Om Prakash Kohli, and formation is in 1st November 1956. Which sailboat has been induced in Indian Navy on 18th February 2017? So the Indian Navy second ocean going sailboat Tarani was induced at the ceremony scheduled to be held at the INS Mandovi boat pool on 18 February 2017. So your answer is Tarini. A is your answer. Which organization has launched a communication radio for the Indian Armed Forces? So there is one organization which launched a communication radio for the Indian Armed Forces, and the name of that organization is BEL, that is Bharat Electronics Limited, and the name of that communication radio is Stars 5th Mark 3rd. Okay, and they displayed at the Aero India 2017 show. And the headquarters of the BEL is at Bangalore, founded in 1954. Chairperson is M.V. Gautama. So your answer is BEL. What will be the new tenure of a chairperson of SEBI? And the new chairperson is Ajay Tyagi. And the government said that the tenure of the next chairperson of the SEBI, Ajay Tyagi, will initially be for the 3 years. Okay. And they will extend if they want. So the headquarters of the SEBI is in Mumbai, Foundation 12 April 1992, and chairperson Ajay Tyagi. How many new airports will be added to the Udaan scheme? So Udaan scheme to increase number of airports by 50, and the total number of airports that will become after this is 125 with successful implementation of Udaan. Okay, so your answer is 50. Which city is hosting Western Regional Agriculture Fair 2017? So Union Minister of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare Shri Radha Mohan Singh inaugurated India Western Regional Agriculture Fair in Bikaner. So your answer is D, in Bikaner. Which city is hosting South Asian Speaker Summit? So South Asian Speaker Summit held in Indore. So your answer is Indore. Which volcano is became active recently? So the Indian only volcano active again, and the name of that this volcano is Barren Island. So your answer is B. And you also need to remember that the National Institute of Oceanography, it is in Goa. India has sanctioned a soft loan of $1 million to Nepal for various infrastructure development program. So India sanctions soft loan up to the $340 million. So your answer is B. T.R. Zeiling has resigned recently. He was the chief minister of which state? So let's see the news. Nagaland chief minister T.R. Zeiling resigns. Okay, so your answer is Nagaland. He was the CM of Nagaland. So your answer is D. What is ICGS Ayush? And the full form of ICGS is Indian Coast Guard Ship. Coast Guard, Indian Coast Guard Ship, ICGS Ayush, commissioned in Kochi. So your answer is B. The full form of ICGS is Indian Coast Guard Ship. This Ayush is a ICGS, and this is with the equipped with the integrated brace system and the machinery control system, that is IBS and MCS. India's first dedicated heliport will open in which city? So India's first dedicated heliport to be open in New Delhi. Okay, so your answer is New Delhi, and it is a project of nearby 100 crore rupees. And this will be owned by the Pawan Hans Helicopter Limited. Which resource kit has been launched recently for adolescent as a part of the Rashtriya Kishore Swasthya Karyakram? Okay, so there is one resource kit which is launched for the adolescent. So, and the name of that resource kit is Sathia. And or there is another mobile app named Sathia Salah. Okay, so you need to remember this, that the resource kit that has been launched for the adolescent is as a part of the Rashtriya Kishore Swasthya Karyakram is Sathia. Now let's see some trade and banking questions. Which bank has launched name and shame campaign? So the name and shame campaign initiated by the Catholic Syrian Bank employees and retirees against willful defaulters in Kerala seems to have started paying dividends. Out of the 30 defaulters identified the bank with due of more than 50 lakh each, 10 borrowers have already approached the bank with a settlement proposal following at 20 locations in the state. Okay, so your answer is Catholic Syrian Bank launched this campaign. Which bank has tied up with the Kerala State Cooperative Consumers Federation to facilitate cashless purchase for its customers? So IDBI Bank ties up with the Consumer Fed. Okay, and the headquarter of the IDBI is in Mumbai. It was founded in 1964, and the CEO of the IDBI Bank is Kishore Kharat. So your answer is IDBI Bank. India rating cuts India GDP forecast for 2016 and 17. So India Rating and Research, a Finch Group company, has cut its growth forecast for Indian GDP for 2017 to 6.8%, lower than its initial estimate of 7.9%. And for the next financial year 2017-18, the agency expects the growth GDP to grow higher at 7.4%, backed by the consumption demand and government spending. So you need to remember that this rating agency forecasted Indian growth as 6.8% from previously 7.9. HDFC Life launches Pragati plan for low income group. Okay, for a it is a traditional life insurance plan that has been specifically designed to empower low income families. From which date merchant discount rate will not be levied on government payments. So the RBI said it will reimburse bank the MDR on debit card used for the payment of tax and non-tax dues to the government of India, and will be applicable from 1st January 2017. So your answer is A. What is the new lending limit for RRB against gold? So RRB can now lend up to 2 lakh against gold. Okay, previously it was 1 lakh and right now they changed it to the 2 lakh. And the total period will be of 12 months from the date of the sanction. So your answer is 2 lakh. Which bank has launched instant chat service for customers? So Citibank has launched instant chat service for customers logged into Citibank online in India. And the headquarters of Citibank is in Mumbai. It was founded in 1902. And the India head of this bank is Pramit Jhaveri. So your answer is Citibank. Citibank has launched instant chat service for customers. IMF has launched South Asian Training and Technical Assistance Center in which city? So IMF, that is International Monetary Fund. Okay, launches South Asian Training and Technical Assistant. So they launched this scheme in New Delhi. Okay, so your answer is New Delhi. D is your answer. And this is a collaborative venture between the IMF, the member countries and or the developed partners. Which bank has tied up with railway to sell general category tickets? Okay, so there is a one bank that tied up with the railway to sell general category tickets. And the bank is SBI. So your answer is B, State Bank of India. Which bank has won National MSME Excellence Award 2017? So Corporation Bank has once again won this National MSME Excellence Award 2017, organized by the Federation of Industry, Trade and Service. And the headquarters of the Corporation Bank is in Mangalore. It was founded in 12th March 1906. CEO and the MD is Jay Kumar Garg. And the tagline of this bank is a premier public sector bank. So your answer is Corporation Bank. B is your answer. Which bank has tied up with the Ministry of Human Resource Development to operationalize the Higher Education Financing Agency? So Canara Bank signs MOU with the HRD Ministry, and the headquarters of the Canara Bank is in Bangalore. It was founded in 1906. Right now the chairperson of the Canara Bank is Manmohan, and the tagline is Together We Can. So this is the tagline of this bank, and this is the bank we tied up with the MHRD, that is the Ministry of HRD, to operationalize the Higher Education Financing Agency. So your answer is Canara Bank. D is your answer. Which bank has launched mobile wallet Batwa? So on the occasion of its 75 Foundation Day, OBC, Oriental Bank of Commerce, has come up with its several digital offering, including launch of a mobile wallet Oriental Batwa. The two MSME schemes that have been launched are Oriental Sanjeevani and the Oriental Budget Hotels and Restaurant. So these are the two schemes that was launched by the Oriental Bank. So your answer is C. Which bank has entered into the MOU with the Daimler India for extending finance to customers for the purchase of commercial vehicles? Okay, so there is one bank which come into the MOU with the Daimler India for extending finance to customers for the purchase of the commercial vehicles. Okay, so the bank which impact with the Daimler India is Karnataka Bank. And some more information that you need to remember is the headquarter of the Karnataka Bank, it's in Bangalore, and it was founded in 1924. Chairperson is Jayaram Bhatt, and the tagline of this bank is Your Family Bank Across India. Okay, so your answer is Karnataka Bank. Now let's see some appointments question. Which country has elected Frank Walter Steinmeier as its president? So Frank elected president of Germany, and it is not the highest position in Germany. Okay, Chancellor is the official head of the government and has the highest profile on the world stage. Okay, and the capital of the Germany is Berlin, currency is Euro, and the Chancellor of the Germany is Angela Merkel. So your answer is Germany. Ravi Shankar has been appointed as a High Commissioner of India to which country? So Ravi Shankar, who is a IFS officer of 1995 batch, has been concurrently accredited as a High Commissioner of India to the Republic of Rwanda with the Republic in Uganda, with the residence in the Uganda. Okay, and presently he was a High Commissioner of India to the Republic of Uganda. And the capital of the Rwanda is Kigali, currency is the franc. President, and you don't need to remember the name of the president or prime minister of this state. Okay, you only need to remember is the capital and the currency. Okay, and your answer is B. who has become the first Indian ever to be promoted by the International Basketball Federation, that is FIBA, as technical delegate. So Norman Isaac became first Indian to be FIBA's technical delegate. So your answer is Norman. D is your answer. Jean-Pierre Lacroix has been named as a new UN peacekeeping chief. He is from which country? So he is a new peacekeeping chief and he is from France. Okay, France Jean named a new UN peacekeeping chief. So your answer is France. Capital of the France is Paris. Currency is Euro and Franc. Prime Minister is the Bernard and the President is the Holland. Vikas Swarup appointed as a High Commission to the Canada. Okay, Minister of External Affairs, spokesperson, that is Vikas Swarup, has been appointed as a new commissioner to Canada. And the capital of the Canada is Ottawa, currency is dollar, and the Prime Minister is Justin. Who has been appointed as the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu? So from the previously Jayalalitha to the Paniriselvam, then after that Shashikala, now and there's another name, that is Palani Swami, has appointed as a Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu. So your answer is A. So the capital of the Tamil Nadu is Chennai. Governor is the Vidyasagar Rao and it was formed. Formation date is 26th January 1950. Who has been appointed as a non-official director of PNB? Non-official director of PNB. So Ranganathan and the Mehta appoints non-official director in IOB and PNB. Okay. So your answer is Mehta. Sunil Mehta has been appointed as a non-official director of PNB. Okay, and the headquarter of the PNB is in New Delhi and it was founded in 1894. CEO and the MD of PNB is Usha. Tagline is the name you can bank upon. And the Indian Overseas Bank headquarter is in Chennai, founded in 10th February. Executive director is Swaminathan and tagline is good people to grow with. Okay, so the Ranganathan and the Mehta appointed as a non-official director in IOB and PNB. 8 executive directors appointed in various banks. Okay, so there are 8 executive directors who has been appointed in the various public sector bank on the recommendation of the Public Board Bureau. The appointment has been made for the 3 years. So these are the few names that has been appointed as a ED. Who has been appointed as Ambassador of India to Montenegro? So Renu Paul appointed Ambassador of India to the Montenegro. Okay, and the capital of the Montenegro is Podgorica, currency is Euro. So these are the 2 things that you need to remember. Okay, and your answer is Renu Paul. Who has been appointed as a CM of Nagaland? So let's see the news. Naga People Front President Shruzo Zail was selected as the consensus candidate by the Democratic Alliance of Nagaland for the post of the CM. Okay, so your answer is D. Nagaland capital is Kohima. It was formed in 1st December 1963. Governor is Padmanabha Acharya. Who has been appointed as a NSA, that is National Security Advisor of USA. So Trump chooses HR McMaster as a National Security Advisor. Okay, and it will take on the role after having served several tours of the duty in Germany, Southwest Asia and Iraq. So your answer is HR McMaster as appointed as a NSA of USA. Now let's see some awards question. Who has won Laureate Sportsperson of the Year Trophy 2017? So Usain Bolt win Sportsman Person of the Year Award and Simone Biles claims the Sportswoman of the Year Award. So these are the 2 names that you need to remember. Okay, and the Comeback of the Year Award goes to Michael Phelps, who has been awarded with the Vyas Samman 2016. Another very important question, friends. And Hindi scholar and writer Surendra Verma selected for the Vyas Samman Award 2016. So your answer is Surendra Verma. Who has been honored with the Legendary Award 2017? So Lata Mangeshkar honored with the Legendary Award 2017. Okay. So your answer is Lata Mangeshkar. Which film has been awarded at the Berlin Film Festival 2017? So there are 2 Indian films at the World Renowned Berlin Film Festival Bang Award, that is Amit Newton's and Amar Abba. Okay. So your answer is A and C, that is D. Now let's see some sports question. Jamshed suspended from all forms of cricket. So it is a left-handed opener from Pakistan, that is Nasir Jamshed, has been provisionally suspended from all forms of cricket by the Pakistan Cricket Board for violating its anti-corruption code. Cricketer Adam Vokes is from which country? So he is a Western Australian batsman, has played 20 tests and he retired from its cricket. Okay, and he is from Australia. So your answer is Adam Vokes is from Australia. Which team has won Shahid Mushtaq Ali Trophy 2017? So there are a few teams like Western Zone, East Zone, North Zone who played this Shahid Mushtaq Ali Trophy. So East Zone claims the claims this title. Okay, so your answer is East. B. Shahid Afridi, who has announced his retirement from the international cricket recently, is from which country? So he's a very famous batsman and named Boom Boom Afridi, and he's from Pakistan. It is a very easy question. Which team has won gold medal at the Asian Women Rugby 7 Trophy? Okay, so India wins silver at the Asian Women Rugby 7 Trophy, and the winner of this tournament is South Korea. So your answer is South Korea, and India won silver medal in this Asian Women Rugby 7 Trophy. Now let's see some death question. Ved Prakash Sharma passed away recently. Who he was? So he was a very famous novelist, writer. So your answer is writer. Zambu Vantro Dote passed away recently. Who he was? So he was a former Nagpur MP. Okay, and he is popularly known as the Lion of Vidarbha. So your answer is politician. Altamas Kabir passed away recently. He was the Dash Chief Justice of India. So recently, one of our ex-Chief Justice of India, Altamas Kabir, passed away, and he was the 39th Chief Justice of India. So your answer is B. Norway Nobel Committee Chairwoman dies at the age of 65. So Cassie Kullmann, the Chairwoman of the Norwegian Nobel Committee, which selects the Peace Prize, has died at the age of 65. So the Norway currency of the Norway is Kron, capital is Oslo, prime minister is Emma. Now let's see some books question. Who is the author of the book titled Hema Malini, Beyond the Dream Girl? Okay, so the author of this book is Ram Kamal Mukherjee. Okay, billed as an authorized biography, Hema Malini, Beyond the Dream Girl is penned by the author, columnist Ram Kamal Mukherjee. So your answer is D. Okay, so these are the friends important question from the third week of the February. And friends, if you are not subscribed our channel till now, then click on this logo to subscribe our YouTube channel for daily videos and for daily newspaper editorials, vocabs and quiz. Download Vocab 24 app now. And if you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to like and share this video with your friends and give your feedback while commenting on this video. So friends, thank you and all the best for upcoming exam. Hope you like this video.